Hello friends. In this video, we will talk about a very interesting and functional Zigbee LED controller from the well-known brand Gladopto, whose devices have repeatedly come to me for testing. The star of this review has several notable features. It is designed for installation on a DIN rail and electrical panels, has a wider input voltage range than most counterparts, and, most interestingly, supports switching operating modes. Essentially, this is 5 controllers in one: a simple dimmer, a controller for white light with adjustable color temperature, a controller for colored light, a controller for colored light with a single channel for white light control, and finally, a controller for colored and white light with adjustable color temperature. In white light mode, the control channels are combined, allowing the use of high-power LED strips. All of this will be covered in more detail later in my review. In the meantime, as usual, I ask you to like this video so that more people interested in smart home technology can find it, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Usually, this section is called Parameters and Delivery, but in this case, the device was given to me for a charity auction held on the Ukrainian version of my Telegram channel. I only received the controller itself, so I don't know what was included in the full package. Let's move on to the stated specifications. Model: Gladopto GL-C011P. Device type: LED strip controller, 5-in-1. Interfaces: Zigbee 3.0, RF 2.4 GHz. Designed for DIN rail installation. Operating voltage: 12, 24, 36, 48, and 54 volts. Maximum current: 5 amps per channel, but no more than 15 amps in total. Operating modes: dimmer, CCT, RGB, RGBW, and RGB CCT. Size: 36 by 59 by 91 millimeters. Occupies the space of 2 standard circuit breakers on a DIN rail. Protection class: IP20. The installation type of this controller determines its design. Since it is intended for installation in electrical panels, it is made in the standard form factor for such devices, occupying a width of 2 units, 36 millimeters. Given that the width of standard circuit breakers is 18 millimeters. On the back side, there is a corresponding mounting bracket. A plastic latch is used for securing it to the rail, which in this case is red. At the top of the device, there are screw terminals for connecting the power supply. They are doubled, allowing the load to be distributed when using high-power LED strips. There are also 2 buttons, one for switching modes. As a reminder, there are 5 of them, and the other for putting the device into pairing mode. Additionally, there is an LED indicator that shows the current mode. At the bottom, there are 6 terminals for connecting LED strips. In RGB CW mode, these are 5 control channels for each color and a common positive terminal. In white light modes, the terminals are duplicated, allowing the load to be distributed and more powerful strips to be used at a rate of 5 amps per channel, but no more than 15 amps in total. On the front panel, there is a table indicating the correspondence between the LED indicator color and the selected mode, as well as the designation of each terminal depending on the chosen mode. For testing, I will use an RGB CCT LED strip operating at 24 volts, which will allow me to check all 5 control channels. For those interested, I will also leave a link in the video description to where I purchased this strip. The LED indicator color corresponds to the selected mode and the connection of the strips. You can use the controller for any type of LED strip by disabling the unused control channels. For RGB CCT, all contacts are used, a common positive terminal and separate controls for red, blue, green, warm white, and cool white. Mode switching is done by briefly pressing the button. An important point, the mode must be set before connecting to the gateway, as the controller is recognized differently in each mode. Here is my test setup: a laboratory power supply set to 24 volts, the controller, and an RGB CCT LED strip. Pairing mode is activated upon first power up, when changing the operating mode, or by holding the reset button. Now let's check compatibility with smart home control systems, starting with Tuya Smart. Since this is a Zigbee device, a gateway is required for the controller to connect. It is currently set to the maximum mode, RGBCW, which corresponds to a white LED indicator. It was recognized in the system as a smart bulb, which, functionally speaking, it essentially is. It will be available both in the general device list and in the gateways list. The plugin is standard. In this mode, there is color control, color temperature adjustment. At any given moment, either the colored or white light can be active, as well as a music mode, in which the strip blinks and changes color in sync with the music detected by the microphone of the controlling smartphone. Everything works correctly. By the way, I like the LED strip I used for testing. It can be used both for main and ambient lighting. It shines quite brightly. What happens if you switch the controller's operating mode? In this example, I switched it to the white light mode with adjustable color temperature, indicated by the green LED. The previously connected device immediately goes offline. It needs to be deleted and reconnected. Now the controller connects as a filament lamp. During testing, I noticed that after switching modes, the controller is often detected incorrectly the first time. For example, as a dimmer in color mode. To fix this, simply delete it and reconnect it immediately without changing anything, and everything will be correct. In this mode, only brightness and color temperature control are available. To keep the review from being overloaded, I will show all 5 operating modes later during testing with ZHA and Zigbee 2 MQTT, as it is more visually informative there, showing the model number, which is unique for each mode. The general information menu contains nothing special, everything is standard. Compatibility with Amazon Alexa and Google Home is stated. Here, there is an option to remove the device from the system, which is useful if the operating mode was detected incorrectly the first time. After removal, the controller automatically enters pairing mode. This is very convenient. You can immediately enable new device edition on the gateway, and the controller will reconnect on its own. Operation and automations follows the standard behavior for such devices within the Tuya Smart ecosystem. The controller can be used in the if section as a trigger, where 3 event options are available. Turning on or off, as well as conditions based on brightness level or set color temperature being greater than, less than, or equal to a specific value. However, such devices are most often used in automation actions. For a complete picture, I have set the maximum operating mode, RGBCW. Available actions include turning the device on or off, and most importantly, toggling its state. You can set the desired brightness level, saturation, and color, or adjust the color temperature in white light mode. In other modes, these actions will be accordingly limited. Let's check the stated compatibility with Google Home. To work with it, you need to connect your Tuya account once through the menu of compatible devices. The connection works via the cloud. The controller appeared in the system and is displayed just like in Tuya, as a light bulb. In this mode, both color and color temperature control are available. When switching modes, the available controls will change accordingly. The system treats each mode as a separate device. While the controller is still connected to the gateway, let's test it in Home Assistant using the standard Tuya integration. Like Google Home, it operates through the cloud. The device is supported here as well. It is displayed as a standard light under the same name as in the Tuya Smart app. Control works simultaneously in both places. In this mode, brightness and color temperature adjustment are available for white light. Additionally, brightness and color selection are available for colored lighting. Now it's time to disconnect from the default gateway and switch to alternative coordinators, starting with the local smart home hub Sunoff iHost. The firmware version at the time of testing was 2.4.2. After disconnecting from the Tuya gateway, the controller entered pairing mode and was discovered by the Sunoff iHost coordinator. The device list displayed an image of one of the Gladopto controllers. The maximum mode, RGBCW, is currently set. The letter R in the top right corner of the tile indicates that this is a Zigbee router. This operating mode corresponds to the model GL-C008P. This is how iHost identified it. I will show the list of all models for each mode a bit later. To keep the review concise, I will only show some of them here, but all are supported. brightness, and color temperature control for white light, as well as hue adjustment for colored lighting, are available. Three standard settings for such devices are also accessible. Everything works correctly, brightness adjusts, white light activates when selecting color temperature, and colored light activates when choosing a hue from the palette. The scheduling function allows you to set the time and day of the week for automatic lighting activation or deactivation. The delay function sets a time interval after which the lighting will turn on or off. The cyclic timer allows you to set periodic on A-off intervals. There is no additional settings menu in the general information section. I remove the controller from the system, switch the mode, the blue LED indicates RGB mode, and reconnect it to iHost. Here, a different Gladopto controller icon is used. In all modes, the Zigbee router function remains. The correct model that should be detected in this mode is GLC003P. If another one appears, delete the controller from the system and reconnect it immediately. In this mode, brightness and color control are available. There is no white light. The red LED indicates the minimal operating mode, dimmer mode. The controller's terminals consist of 1 positive and 5 negative contacts. The correct model under which the device should appear as a dimmer is GLC009P. It can be turned on, off, and its brightness can be adjusted. In iHost automations, turning on and off can be used as a trigger. For actions, options include turning on, turning off, and toggling the state. Additionally, lighting parameters can be adjusted depending on the active mode, from simple brightness control to brightness, color, and color temperature adjustments. SunOff iHost is also connected to Google Home, but now locally, using the Matter protocol. The controller is supported in this configuration as well. From the main menu, it can be turned on and off. In the dedicated plugin, all control options available in the selected mode are accessible. Naturally, it can also be controlled via Voice Assistant. Returning to Home Assistant, but this time without using the Tuya gateway. First, I will test the standard Zigbee integration, ZHA, using a USB stick with SkyConnect firmware as the coordinator. I navigated to its tab, then removed the controller from SunOff iHost and clicked the Add Device button. The RGB CW mode is currently set, indicated by the white LED. The correct model that should be detected is GLC008P. In addition to the standard light entity, several other options are available here: state memory mode and initial values for color and color temperature. For state memory, there are 4 modes: always turn on when powered, always stay off, toggle to the opposite state. This can be used, for example, for momentary switches, or remember the last state. Brightness control, color temperature adjustment, and color selection from preset options are available. There is even one effect, but it works strangely. The light just blinks once and that's it. Color hue selection from the palette is also available. RGBW mode controls the colored mode, while white light has only 1 channel brightness. The LED color is yellow, model GLC007P. The list of available entities does not differ from the previous mode. Everything works exactly the same. The color mode operates similarly. White light control is also displayed, but in reality, only 1 channel of brightness is functional. RGB mode, only colored light, LED color is blue, model GLC003P. The list of entities remains unchanged. However, in this mode, I found an issue with ZHA. Only color temperature adjustment is available, even though the white light channels are disabled. I reconnected the controller several times, but the result was always the same. CW mode, only white light with color temperature adjustment, LED color is green, model GLC006P. Here, everything remains unchanged. And the control is now correct, brightness and color temperature adjustments are needed in this mode. The minimal mode, dimmer, only brightness control. LED color is red, model GLC009P. One option was removed here, the initial color setting, but everything else is the same. Everything works correctly, only brightness is controlled. In ZHA, all modes except RGB work properly, but, in general, One of the more advanced modes can be used instead. And, as usual, I conclude testing with the Zigbee 2 MQTT integration. The test was conducted on version 2.1.0, starting with the maximum operating mode. I remove the controller from ZHA, switch modes using the button until the LED turns white, and start pairing with Zigbee 2 MQTT. For RGBCW, the model is GLC008P, and the description states that this version supports RGB plus CCT. The Exposes page includes many options on AOF, brightness adjustment, color temperature control, and initial startup modes. Two methods for selecting the color hue, a list of effects, power restoration behavior settings, and even an identification button. The state memory function works correctly. I tested all the modes. There are more effects here than in ZHA, but honestly, I don't see much use for them. When activated, the strip just blinks, and that's it. RGBW mode, model GLC007P, different image, different description. Although there is still one white light control channel, the Exposes list remains unchanged. Color temperature, just like in ZHA, is available but does not actually work. Only brightness control is functional for white light. Everything else works the same, including state memory, which is quite important. RGB mode, only color, model GLC003P, corresponding description. By the way, in every case when switching modes, I always had to reconnect the controller a second time to get the correct model detection. White light control is gone here, as expected for this model. Only color control remains. CW mode, warm and cool white light, blending to adjust color temperature. Model GLC006P. The Exposes page corresponds accordingly, with brightness control and options for current and initial color temperature settings. Here's an example of incorrect detection. Immediately after switching modes, the Zigbee model number and actual model differed. In one place, it displayed correctly, while in another, the previous mode remained. We remove the device from the system, which automatically activates pairing mode. Immediately reconnect, and now everything is correct. For the dimmer mode, the model is GLC009P, with only one control channel. Accordingly, apart from on AOF, state memory, and effects, only brightness control is available. For those planning centralized LED strip control with installation in an electrical panel, this controller appears to be a very interesting option. The advantages include a wide operating voltage range, up to 54 volts, and support for all possible operating modes. There's no need to calculate how many different controllers are needed for different strips. This model can handle everything. CW mode for task lighting, RGB for ambient lighting, and the maximum mode for a universal setup. It offers good compatibility with control systems, with the only missing integration being HomeKit. That's all for now. I hope this video was helpful and interesting for you. I would appreciate your likes. They help with promotion on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I will leave links to stores where you can order this controller, my Telegram channels and social media, as well as discussion groups on smart home topics. Join in, it will be interesting. Thank you for your attention. See you next time. Peace to all.